It is 9:46. Thanks so much for being with us on Live at 9, and it's Make a Difference Monday. A Mid-South partnership is working to help support those who care for family members who cannot care for themselves.
And one key factor, of course, is caregiving, is communication. Here to explain more about that and their work are Janice Williams with Caregivers and Dr. Joy Goldsmith with the University of Memphis. Ladies, welcome. Glad to have you here.
Thank you.
It seems like at one point in all of our lives, you will come across that one person who is that caregiver.
Yes.
But a lot of us don't realize what that individual or individuals go through, do we not?
Yes. Actually, family caregivers go through a whole lot of things. And there is statistics out there that say when you start caregiving, you become statistics. Mm-hmm. You become at risk for not taking mm-hmm. care of yourself as well as you take care mm-hmm. of your loved one.
Right.
Depression, isolation, financial concerns. So many things affect family caregivers.
And the word respite in your organization's name is so important, because for those who are professionally caregivers, they're sort of that nurturing personality. They know how to do this.
Right.
For many of us who become caregivers, and both of you have been,
right.
You may not be that personality, so you need to what? Be able to pull away and be nurtured?
Yes.
But how do you get that?
Doctor, what do you say?
Well, I say about 1 in 4 of us are caregivers, so it's not rare. And if you haven't been a caregiver, the chances that you will be a family caregiver are extremely high. And we know that the family caregiver is about my age,
mm-hmm.
Late 40s, is still working a full-time job,
mm-hmm.
takes hits to their pocketbook, to their social life, to their mental health, and it is all sort of invisible and integrated, and the healthcare system really depends on the family caregiver. So we're trying to make the invisible visible and network caregivers together and also advocate for the resources that are out there.
With that in mind, should there be, is there more of a safety net these days for caregivers?
Safety net. I think actually our organization started in 2010. And since then, I have seen the growth of people talking more about caregiving, mm-hmm. caregiving yeah. situations. And so more support is going that way. Safety net, if I could answer that in this way. What we're trying to do with everything that we do for family caregivers is we want to encourage them to get connected,
mm-hmm.
and that's their safety net. One thing doesn't fix all of their situation problems.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
But if they get connected with our organization, they can grow, they can get breaks, they can flourish, they can learn new things to support them on their caregiving journey.
And doesn't it begin with the knowing they need to raise their hand and admit to themselves, I need somebody, I need to talk to somebody who's been
right.
through this?
Yes. Right, and there's a cost to what I'm doing. There's,
right.
I'm not
and,
sleeping.
And that's okay. It doesn't make me a bad person
right.
that I'm stressed.
Right, and some of it is really not fun, and that's okay too. So
yeah.
finding like a soft place to land with some resources is so, so crucial.
So how
and as
people-
we also pointed out earlier, though, one of the major keys is communication.
Yeah.
What else can we do? What else can caregivers do and those on the other side do as well there?
Communication is a huge burden. Like, we think of it as something that just comes naturally and easy, but it is major work for the caregiver because they are the conduit mm. between the providers,
yeah.
the healthcare system, the insurance mm-hmm. machines, the other family members.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's huge cost.
Yeah.
And so giving caregivers resources and tools for making that process, that communication mm-hmm. work, sort of more readily available and easy for them is part of what we want to do.
Because as you mentioned, they also have kids, they have a job, they have all this other stuff
mm-hmm.
over here. So
right.
you we just put an event on the screen that you mm-hmm. guys are doing. Is that what people will learn at this event? How to open up those lines of communication and make it more effective so that they get the help they need?
Yes. And also, well, communicating with your healthcare professional is key.
Yeah.
Also, we're going to help them recognize barriers. Because
yeah.
we can't, this workshop is a health literacy training. And health literacy, you don't readily say, oh, I need help communicating.
Right.
But if you come, mm-hmm. you'll see that you do.
Right.
Because care for caregivers, the care that caregivers give has become more complex.
Yes.
Healthcare has changed. Mm-hmm. We need to be, as family caregivers, up on everything.
So it'll show you the gaps and then help fill them.
Right. Thank
you. We appreciate you all being here, having this conversation with us about an extremely important topic.
Yes.
Thank you. They also have a great website. We'll link to that.
All right.